I have a lovely letter to present it. Even in case you need it, you can show it up here. Yeah, I think I will really enjoy it because I'm dedicated to my girl outside there. And if she's there looking at me, I think maybe tonight she'll feel okay.
Today I want to learn more about love and relationship stuff.
Today I expect to be lively and interesting. Yeah.
It will be better than the last time, but the last one was nice. I liked it.
Amazing, and I love you all. And as always, look at the person next to you and tell them I love you. Come on. Welcome to yet another episode of Jessie's Love Letter. I'm your host, Jessie Height, and as you can see, I'm all soaked up in L-O-V-E. See you all the time, you with your homegirls, and I'm knowing everybody, how are you guys? No, it's Hamjamboni. Like I always tell you, this is the only place you get to experience love first class. So it's juicy and delicious, and it just takes you down and makes you melt. So bonjour tout le monde, and it is bienvenue to yet another episode of Jessie's Love Letter, your home of
L-O-V-E.
Look at the person next to you. Macho kwa macho, look them deep in the eyes. Deep in the eyes, so deep that it can't get any deeper. Are you looking at them? Now tell them nakupenda. Today we'll do it in Swahili. Tell them nakupenda.
Lately I've been trying to tell you something, trying to find the nerve enough to come and say.
We are going to be talking about something very important. They have raised us since we were little. They have taken care of us. They have loved on us. They have cared for us. And I'm talking about our parents. It's so hard to trust anyone that even when you're in a relationship, you will not work on it. You consider cheating. So today we are asking, how exactly do you catch a cheater? Is there something to do with age and relationships? Or is it just okay to fall in love with a 100-something-year-old man? Well, today in your home of love, that's what we are about to find out. A relationship is not a give from one person and a take from another. It is a matter of a give and take from both parties. So today we are going to be talking about what should a good relationship be about. Maybe you got into a relationship because of money. You want the mullah, chop the money. How do you let go of the past? How do you let go of disappointments? You lost someone probably to a natural cause such as death. Or someone left you, someone broke your heart, kaikanyaga na kasema it's over. How do you let go?
Years have come and gone, friends have come and gone. Then as I look back, I realize I don't lack a friend to call my own, for you I have known over the years, and you're still here. And all I have to say is, you're still beautiful. The beauty of your true friendship, your warm embrace, your sincere smile, your caring heart, and your tender sentiments transcends the mere word friend. Because when I look at you, I see you in a different light. Candlelight, moonlight, sunlight.
I don't take it for granted that I have you. Sometimes we disagree on various things and take different directions, but still get over it. A philosopher once said, "The strength of a ship is not measured by material made to build it, but by the number of storms it has gone through successfully." And we can be put in this category because we are a strong family. Dad and Mom, I cannot even start to thank you for the care, love, and support. Sometimes we don't agree because I think I'm too old to make my own decisions.
We truly loved each other. On the 18th August 2010, my love was taken away by death. It kept me silent and made my life dark. Each day I would wish death was not there. Rebecca, my love, happiness and joy was no more. The dreams were no more, and the happiness we had been put into silence. The smiles and laughter that you always enlightened us with was gone. Death, had taken away my happiness and was not ready even for negotiations. Death, why are you so heartless, ruthless? Love is the flower of life and blossoms unexpectedly and without law and must be plucked where it is found.
Wow, wow, wow. Beautiful. Oh! Come on up here.
This is my special lady.
Wow, isn't she beautiful? Now, Steve.
Yes.
You have to go along with Adele.
All right.
Now, her eyes are there and they're so lovely. Now, you look into them.
All right.
And tell her those special things that, you know, probably you've not told her today or this minute because you're up here. Now, tell them to her.
Babe, you mean everything to me. For all the times that I have been less than I should have been, I say sorry for all the beautiful things that you do for me, for all the sacrifices, for all the love, for the blessing, that you are to me. I love you, Lydia. I love you very much. You're a blessing to me. You've changed my life. And may God continually bless you for the blessing that you are to me. I did it.
Oh my God. Look at baby. She's tears. Come on, give them a round of applause.
When I assess myself, I see me empty with nothing to give. My heart yearns for you like a dry land thirsts for water. So stay. I know you have a million reasons to leave, but at least look for one good one to stay. Because when you leave, some parts of me will be gone forever. The rest will live on, but will make me weak and quiver, like I was naked in the middle of winter. So I want you to stay. I want you to be there for me. You used to love me despite my faults. Forgave me when I shattered your heart not once, but a couple of times. And in your presence, yes, in your presence, my heart will not shame. So stay. Will this world make better sense once you mean nothing to me? Tell me, I'd like to know. I'd rather be dead, sleeping 6 feet deep down in my grave than be alone, nursing wounds of unintending to your heart. So stay. I want you. I want no one else. My heart is chained to you and I can't get free. Look what this love's done to me. I'm not strong enough to get away.
Oh Lord, my God, how excellent is your name in all the earth, who have shown your glory above the heavens. The earth is the Lord's and all its fullness, the world and all who dwell therein. So who am I that you, God, are mindful of me? And the Son of Man that you visit me. Tell me, what is man that you, God, are mindful of him? Thou preparest a table for me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, and my cup it runneth over. Remember, O Lord, your tender mercies and your loving kindness, for they are from old. All your parts, they are mercy and truth. Many, many, O Lord, are the wonderful works that you have done, and your thoughts towards us, they cannot be recounted back to you. Mercy and truth, they go before your face, Lord. Righteousness and justice, they are the foundations of your throne. Mercy and truth, Lord, they go before your face. Who am I, Lord, that you are mindful of me? And just a son of man that you visit me, Lord. Who is man, Lord, that you You, God, are mindful of him. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not his benefits. Who has healed your iniquities? Who has forgiven your sins? Who has